Hello guys, welcome back with me, Ciao Ciao 2025. Today we're going to learn to install Reactor on Forge and Automatic1111. Reactor for stable diffusion is the fast and simple phase swap extension with a lot of improvements and without NSFW filter. That it mean it is uncensored, so use it with responsibility. The first thing you do before this is to have either Automatic1111 or Forge. I put the link on the description about how to install them. I also put link of how to install Reactor in Comfy UI. Now, you need to install Visual Studio 2022. Link also on the description. Check the link. You only need to download the community Visual Studio, so it's free. After that, open the installation. And select desktop development with C++ under workloads, desktop or mobile. You could also install many other thing if you want. Click download and install and wait until the process is finished. I already do that so I can't show you, but it is pretty simple. You could refer my video on the link on the description of how to do that. Next, access the SD web UI. In this example, I use Forge. Access extension tab. Click available and click load from. After that, a list of available extension will show up. Simple search Reactor. After you see that, click the install button located to the right of the table. Wait the installation process to be finished. After it finished, go to installed. Check if SD web UI Reactor is there. After you check it, click apply and restart UI. After that, a new menu will show up below called Reactor. Click enable. Put any face there and generate an image. The image you put will be using your face from the source image. It is better than Roop in so many ways. Here are the example. You could say this thing is fast. There are a lot options here. First, you could do save original to also save the picture before you change the face. Then face mask correction. It help if you have some pixelation around face contours. If there is no such case, I hardly suggest you to use it, because there's almost no difference at the result. But using that use, extra model and time. Now about face index, there is source image index and target image index. Reactor detects faces in images in the following order. First, left. Then right. Then top. Then lastly, bottom. So source index is if on you source image, you have more than one face. You need to select which face will be used. Here are some example. Where I put the first face as index 0. And here I put the second face as index 1. Now, you could put more than one index at once. If you want, like index, one source replace index, one target. Also, you could skip a face. Make sure you don't put space after the comma, or else the second index will be ignored. Here are an example. Here, another example. You could also change face in image to image. Make sure the denoise is 0. Also, you could upload an image with the same face. It will still recognize as two different faces. Also, you could use one face to change more than one target face image. Either you use 0 and 0 source like in this example to change 0 and 1 target, or you could use one index to change 0 and 1. Gender detection source and image will detect if your source or target gender is true according to your selection. This will help if you create an uncontrolled generation or if you use it for video. I never see use case on regular generation thought. When the gender detection detect the gender is not what you define, it will not change or swap the face. So there will be an extra checking with that. Will cost you extra process. It also will not change index face position. Last option is restore face. You could do CodeFormer or GFGain. I already explained this in upscaling, so I will put that link on description. The simple definition is that this two algorithm will help you repair the face. I myself prefer CodeFormer. I usually reduce the visibility a little. And increase the weight a little. But play with it according to your taste. I really suggest you use this. It costs you a lot of time for this, but the result is worth it. Anyway, guys, I think that's it for today's video. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and comment. See you again on the next episode. And have a nice day. Please subscribe.